Welcome to exercise one. Make sure that you've downloaded the tutorial image files to begin this exercises. The two images in this exercise are called Buddha.jpg and texture.jpg. So make sure you have both of those opened for this exercise. The next thing I want you to do is go to Window, Arrange, to up vertical. This is a great option that lets you see both images that you have opened in Photoshop at the same time. So you can see on the left of my screen, I have the Buddha JPEG open, and on the right of my screen, I have the texture JPEG open. Locate the Move tool in your toolbar. It's the very first one at the top of the toolbar, or you can hit V to have it activated fast in the toolbar. So I'm just gonna go ahead and click on that tool. And then I'm going to make sure that I have the texture tab activated. And I'm gonna simply click on the texture image and holding down my mouse, I'm going to drag it into the Buddha and release it. So I now have in my Buddha JPEG, the texture image and the Buddha image. So now I'm going to go ahead and close the texture JPEG because I don't need it anymore. So I want you to locate your layers panel if you don't have it open. If you don't have it open, remember you can go to Window, Layers, and that panel will pop open. And in this panel, you'll see that you have two layers. I have layer one, which the thumbnail is showing the texture background. And I have another layer called background, which is my Buddha image. So the first thing that we're going to do is with layer one activated, which is my texture, I want you to go up and change the levels, which is the shadows and highlights or midtones of this image. And where we're going to find that is under image adjustments. So we're going to go to image, adjustments, levels. A box is going to appear that has these little sliders. You'll see three of them. The one on the far left is going to adjust the shadows. And the one on the far right is going to adjust the highlights. And the one in the middle is going to adjust the midtones. So I'm going to just choose anything. I just want you to experiment and play with these sliders so you'll see how they affect the cause and effect. So I'm going to adjust my midtones a little bit, and I'm going to go ahead and hit OK. The next thing I want you to do is become familiar with blending modes. So there's a couple different places to access blending modes, but the first place I want you to become familiar with layer one selected in your layers panel and highlighted with this light gray, is this drop-down menu where you'll see normal. If you open up this drop-down menu, you'll see that you have many different blending modes. You have dissolve, darken, multiply, color burn, linear, the list goes on. And as you slowly drag through these, you'll see that these are effects that you can easily apply to your layers. I just want you to choose one that you think is the most interesting. For example, I think I'm going to go up and use overlay. You'll see once I release the mouse on overlay that with layer one selected, texture image, that you can see overlay is selected in my blending mode drop-down menu. So once you've done these few little tweaks to your image, the last thing I want you to do is I want you to practice saving this as a Photoshop file or a .psd. And again, the way that you do this is by going File, Save As. This option will appear. Do you want to save on your computer or to cloud? I'm going to go ahead and save this on my computer. And I want you to become very familiar with how to name files. So this is the best way to save files. I'm going to place my cursor in front of the word Buddha. And I'm going to want you to do your last name. So for example, my last name is Chan. And then I'm going to do an underscore on my computer. Then my first name, Nicole, underscore. And we're going to call this Buddha1. And .psd. So this is a Photoshop native format. So that means when I open this PSD file up again, my layers or working file will be available for me to edit and change. I want this layer box checked because I want my layers to be kept, and I'm going to go ahead and hit save. The last thing I want you to do is to submit this final file using the Submit Exercise 1 Buddha button on the Canvas page to get credit for this exercise.